I want to work you through today some examples of simplifying expressions that have square roots and variables involved. You'll remember from previous lessons that in order to do this, you have to have like terms in order to combine your expressions, in order to simplify your expressions. They have to be like terms. And in order to do that, you're going to have to simplify underneath the square root sometimes in order to get like terms. This 2x square root of 2x, you can't do anything with that. That's as simple as it can get. The 3 times it, that's as simple as you can get. But this square root of 8x, 8 is not a perfect square, but if you factor it, you can factor it into 4 times 2 times x. And 4 is a perfect square. So we're gonna have to reduce this and simplify. The square root of 4 is 2 times the square root of 2x. Now we've got like terms. We have 2 square root of 2x plus 3 square root of 2x. Now that I've got my like terms, I can combine those like terms to get 5 times the square root of 2x. And that is as simple as we can get. Next example, again, we don't have like terms yet, but we can work at it and get things that are like terms. The 4 times, can't do anything with 4 out front, so we just leave it. The square root of 5x to the third power, we can simplify that. We'll write the 4. The square root of 5 is just the square root of 5. We can't do much with it. And the square root of x to the third, though, we can simplify that. We can think of x to the third as x squared times x to the first. Remember our rules for dealing with exponents. We would add those exponents. 2 plus 1 gives you the 3 on that. And the square root and the square undo each other. So we would end up with 4 times the square root of 5. The square root of x squared is x. Square root of x to the first just stays as the square root of x to the first. And now this can be arranged with the 4 and the x written out front, 4 times x, and the 5 times the square root of x still underneath the square root symbol. So this whole thing simplifies to 4x times root 5x. And this second term, the 4x, we can't really do anything with because it's outside the square root. But the square root of 20x, we can simplify that. We can rewrite our square root of 20 as 4 times 5 times x. We can evaluate the square root of 4, which is 2. So we have 4x times 2. And then what's left underneath the square root is the 5x. And finally, we simplify. The 4x times 2 is 8x, and we have the square root of 5x still. At this point, we now have like terms, and we can combine our like terms, 4x plus 8x. It's important that those are like terms also. They're both x to the first power, x to the first power. If they weren't, if we just had like 4x plus 8, we couldn't combine it because they're not like terms. You know, you could do some other things. You could factor out a 5x, but I'm not gonna get into that right now. But we can combine our like terms. 4x plus 8x is equal to 12x. And our common term, our like quote-unquote variable type of term, our root term is 5x. So 4x times root 5x plus 8x times root 5x is 12x times root 5x. Couple more examples. Again, we don't have what appears to be like terms, but we have to simplify things. We have 4, which we know the square root of 4 is 2. And the root of b to the third, when we're dealing with variables here, I just want to look at a pattern here. Square root of b is just square root of b. We can't do anything with it. We have the square root of b squared. Square root of b squared is b because we can take the square root and the square undo each other. if we have the square root of b to the third. We rewrite that b to the third as square root of b squared times b. Well, the square root of b squared we said is b, so it becomes b, and what's left is the square root of b. So basically what we're doing here, when we have an odd power for our exponent, we're taking one less than that and then dividing it by 2. And we're always going to be left with a b or an x or whatever our variable is. That's when it's odd. If it's even, like the square root of b to the fourth, we just divide that b to the fourth by 2, because kind of background here, we rewrite it as b squared and b squared. Well, the square root of b squared is b. The square root of the other b squared is b. B times b is equal to b squared. So we just divide this power by 2 when it's even. B to the fourth comes out as b squared. If we have square root of b, let's say, to the 81st, I would rewrite this as square root of b to the 80th times b. We divide this 80 by 2 to get b to the 40th when it comes out of the square root, and we're left with the square root of b inside. So that's kind of some background for how to deal with these square roots of variables. So this b to the third, we already said it comes out as b times root b. So I will just write that. 2 comes from the square root of 4. The square root of b to the third is b times square root b. Plus, square root of 81 is 9. Square root of b to the third is, again, b times square root b. So we're getting like terms. And then minus the square root of 16 is 6. The square root of b to the 6, 6 is even, so we divide it by 2 to get b to the third power. And we combine our like terms, and you'll notice here that our like term is just this and this. So 2b times root b plus 9b root b combines to be 11b times root b. And then we still have our minus 6b to the third. And that is as simple as it can get. We're done, because we don't have any more like terms. Now, the last example that we've got here, there's a couple of things going on. We have to make sure we simplify our roots so we can combine like terms with the roots, but we also have to get a common denominator in order to add fractions. So I'm going to deal with the denominator first. Our common denominator between 6 and 5 is 30, so that means I need to multiply the 6 by 5 in order to get the 30. If I do it to the numerator, I do it to the denominator. So 5 times 7 is 35 times the root 6, and that's over 30. Plus, with this, I have to multiply both numerator and denominator by 6 to create our common denominator of 30. So I end up with 6 square root 24 over 30. So now I've got a common denominator. Next step is I've got to get my roots to be the same so I can really combine these things. Square root 6, we can't simplify anymore. The square root of 24, I'm just going to kind of do this off to the side. And the square root of 24 factors into 4 times 6. So I can rewrite this as square root of 4 times 6. The square root of 4 is 2 times root 6. So I rewrite this again, 35 root 6 over 30 plus 6 times 2 root 6 over 30. The 6 times 2 is equal to 12, so I've got the 35 root 6 over 30 plus 12 root 6 over 30. And now I can combine my like terms. 35 plus 12 is 47 root 6 still, and it's all over 30. And that is as simple as it gets. I hope this helps a little bit. Have a wonderful day.